People always got a way of comparing, or who was the best. Who was the best? You know, we run that all the time. People ask me all the time, who was the greatest Spur? This is what I tell people. I say, you look at it like it's a tree. You got the roots. We all know what roots are to a tree, right? Then you got the trunk. We all know that comes from the roots. And then you got the branches and the flowers and the leaves. I'm the roots. I'm the foundation of this franchise. So you ask yourself, who is the greatest Spur of all time?
The Virginia Squires of the ABA will not go down as one of the greatest teams ever, but they did have two of the greatest players ever, who were just starting to make a name for themselves, Julius Erving and George Gervin.
Oh, what a move by Gervin. Unbelievable.
Great score. He almost traveled with the ball. How does George make it look so easy?
George Gervin was not a guard. George Gervin was a basketball player. George Gervin was not a guard. He was a god. What he could do with all the different skills and his sense of the openings, and he was at a different speed than everybody else.
Handle on to get the rebound. Gervin will have three to make two. He's a good free throw shooter. Let's see what he's made of.
I think my favorite time is when I first started playing professional basketball with the Virginia Squires, and I had an opportunity to come to Virginia and play with Julius Erving. I think that's really my highlight of my career, my beginning.
And I didn't know anything about basketball, but I knew something about athletes. And the first time I saw him, I knew this guy is a superstar. Now, keep in mind, they had Julius Erving. They had a guy named Charlie Scott. They had some great players.
Well, you know, I was a part of the Squires, and George was a teammate of mine's, and the Squires was having such a hard time financially. So Earl Foreman had to figure out a way to pay his bills.
It would be extremely difficult to face a major league franchise, let us say in the state of Virginia, in one specific city.
Foreman, who owned the Virginia Squires, he was a little shady as an owner in taking advantage of the rules and so forth.
The commissioner knew that we were talking to Norfolk, and we were in a league meeting in New York, and he opened the meeting by saying, I'm freezing the roster on the Virginia team. If we sell any players off there anymore, then I won't be able to sell that team. So knowing we weren't supposed to, knowing that he had the authority as a commissioner, we still went against that and did everything against what our parents had taught us, to be honest and straightforward. And we were able to make a deal to buy the Iceman.
And they said they were willing to trade Gervin, but they needed to wait. They were going on a four-game road trip, and they had injuries, and they needed Gervin to stay. Gervin, the next three games, scores 29, 31, and 37 points. I remember my father and Bob were quite excited about the deal that they had just made. The last game on the road trip, they get a call from the general manager in Virginia, and the general manager said, well, Bob, there's been a change. We're not going to trade Gervin to the Spurs. And Bob and my dad said, well, we have an oral contract. It's not in writing. Well, Virginia decided they're gonna change their mind.
So I got a telegram saying, now you are a San Antonio Spur from Angelo DeRosa's, and that, you know, you can't play for the Virginia Squires tonight. So obviously I didn't know all this was going on. And I called my agent at that time, his name was Irvin Wiener. And I say, Irv, what's going on, man? I get this telegram and they're telling me not to play. What's going on? And he say, well, you just got traded to the San Antonio Spurs. They bought your contract from Virginia Squad, so don't play tonight.
Do not attempt to go on to the court in Salt Lake City, or a federal marshal will be there to greet you. Well, I think that message was well received, and Gervin left the building and got on a plane and came to San Antonio.
The other funny thing about that, the owner said, I've got to have cash. So called the Frost Bank, said, you gotta get a guy to take this cash to National Airport in Washington, D.C. and go to a phone booth. And we'd been given the instructions as to how we had to deliver the money. And then wait for that phone to ring, and when it does, then the guy's gonna tell you where to go next. So it was really like a CIA kind of a program.
They had purchased his contract for cash. And the commissioner said, Virginia, I know what you're doing. You're selling contracts to get money to operate on it, and I'm gonna void this deal. But he was already down here, so they put him in a hotel, said, don't come out for anything.
At the Hilton Del Rio, right on the Riverwalk right now, the same hotel is not the Hilton Del Rio, but that was the name of it. And I stayed there, you know, a good month or so. You know, I couldn't practice with the team. You know, I mean, I really couldn't do nothing. So it was an unbelievable experience for me. I used to walk that river, man, and, you know, what I'm gonna do? I mean, I'm 19, and, you know, I didn't know what to do.
In listening to the testimony that first day in the court, just the question the judge was asking the attorneys on each side, I didn't feel very comfortable. I felt like we were probably gonna lose just by the tone of his questions. But along about 2 hours into the testimony that second day, Judge Spears just out of the blue rapped down. He said, I've heard all of this, I wanna hear. You may have a business called the American Basketball Association. You may have bylaws. You may have people agree to bylaws. But that does not supersede the Constitution of the United States. And you're not gonna tell a man where he can work and where he can't work. Boom, fining for the Spurs all the way.
It just so happens that the federal court was in San Antonio and saw it the Spurs way.
Yeah, San Antonio judge granted that George Gervin could play in San Antonio. Sounds fair to me.
George Gervin was sent to San Antonio, where he blossomed as one of the ABA's best players. The question was, how would he do in the NBA? The answer would come soon enough.
It was official. I was a San Antonio Spur.
And people realized quick that he was a pretty good player, that we were lucky to have him.
And I just thought that was the turning point. I mean, getting the franchise here obviously was the big deal, but getting Ice in a Spurs uniform was the second big deal for this city.
There's very, you know, exciting crowd. There's so much for us that they just can't help themselves. You know, they just, you know, really show how they feel about us. And, you know, with that kind of support, we can't do nothing but win down here.
Gervin scored again and again and again and yet again until he had broken 23 team records and scored more points than any other player in the NBA. The most popular Spur by a vote of the fans.
Yes, you know, San Antonio is a great place for me. You know, I've been loved playing here ever since I came. San Antonio is my town, and this is where I love to play at.
I'm the roots. I'm the foundation of this franchise. How about that?